So you ever been in a fist fight? You ever been to a fight? Got beat up? I get beat up all the time by my daughter. We play Monster almost every day. I got a world and chase her. And you know she had the nerve, the audacity to say to me, "Daddy, we never play Monster." I said, "What? We play Monster all day long." And I wish she gets happy. I get, she starts running. She likes it. Starts running around. She runs in my legs. She jumps. I run. I start looking for her. She's like, "Count." I'm like, 1, 2, 3. And I thought I started chasing her. You know, it's like I'm chasing her and being that monster. And that's what I'm telling you right now, church. There's a lot of things chasing us that we don't even know about. Disappointment. A lot of hate. A lot of envy. But the Bible says the Bible is your sword. Hallelujah. Put your hands together. We need to swing our swords. The devil, he's chasing us all the time. But stop giving him glory. Turn around and fight. Fight. God's word is your sword. Fight the word. You can only fight the devil with God's word. And I want to talk about the first thing I wanted to talk to you guys about today is God's word is your sword. Swing. Speak things in existence. Speak existence. When you speak about things, start talking in advance. Start talking about in advance. Stop talking about the things you can't get. My wife, I'm proud of her. Y'all put y'all's hands together. She's had 40 jobs in this year. I'm so happy. I'm just playing. She actually left a job because they wasn't paying her enough. So she was like, "I'm quitting." She put a letter up under the door, and she just put it up under the door. And then the boss, 2 days later, texts her like, why'd you leave us, the boss? So she went to this job. She thought it was going to be a big job, making all this money. She says every single night she works at a nursing home, these people beat her up. They beat her up. I think it's called memory, she says she's in. She comes home every day. I'm telling you, it's like the monster chasing her. Ah, she goes in the face, black eye. I'm like, what's going on? Every single day, she's getting beat up. So one day, we prayed about it. So she's sitting there 2 weeks later. Tell me why her old job texts her back. The boss, the big boss texts her back. Not just the boss. Somebody say big boss texts her back. He texted her back and said, "Please come back. Please come back." She was like, "Oh, did you?" She said, "Baby, my boss texted me. They want me to come back. But they gonna pay me this time." So hallelujah. They paid her $3.45 an hour. Put your hands together. You see what God can do? God can change all those no's into yes. He can change all the no's into yes. He will change all the no's into yes. We was listening to the song. You see, God, when he answers prayers, he says yes. He's not telling you no. Disappointments, people, addictions, every day is going to be a constant battle. You're going to fight against something every day in your life. Your kids. Does anybody fight with their kids every day? Come on now. Oh, the kids even raised their hand. The kids fight with kids. You're going to fight every single day. It's going to be a fight. No matter what you do, no matter what you say, you're going to be fighting something every day. The Bible says it's a spiritual battle. You're going through things every single day. You look in the mirror sometimes. I know I look better now. I look in the mirror. I'm like, man, I look good. Have y'all ever looked in the mirror and be like, man, where that wrinkle come from? Oh, my God. I'm getting old. I know my birthday, I'll be 50. Looking in the mirror, I'm like, yes. Have you ever looked in the mirror, anybody? Say you're getting old? Oh, yeah. Everybody raise their hand? No, my cousin is beautiful. She ain't getting old. No wrinkles. Come on now. Every day we have to fight. We are fighting a battle against ourselves, y'all. It's not against everybody else. You're fighting things against yourself. You're talking about things you can't do, things you haven't done. Every single day, it's a battle. It's a challenge. But you got to swing your sword every single day. Angels will work in your behalf. Put y'all's hands together. Hallelujah. I want y'all to go to the scripture. Hebrews 4, verse 12. Hebrews 4, verse 12. If you're not there, say, hold them up. If you're there, say, amen.
Amen.
All right. Come on up and make me read that scripture.
God is alive and powerful. It is sharper than the sharpest two-edged sword, cutting between souls and spirits, between joints and marrow. It exposes our innermost thoughts and desires.
Hallelujah. Put y'all's hands together now. The word of God is alive. God's word is alive. It is sharper than a two-edged sword. Everything about God is real. I don't want y'all to pray like in the name of pastor. You can't put nothing in my name, in God's name. You got to put something in God's name because pastor can't do nothing for you. can't do nothing. You can ask my wife yesterday. I'm looking for this little bitty, my music. I've been looking for my music about 2 hours. She's tearing up the house, calling her, I'm mad at her. I'm like, you ain't seen my music? It's a flash drive. I'm tearing everything up. Big dude's a big guy like me, so he ain't finna look and find nothing. We looking, tearing up, and I've been to the church. Man, we fought so long, I called her. She comes straight out to the car, comes back in the house 2 seconds later, said, y'all looking for this? What? She found it in 2 seconds. You see, a lot of people got different talents than you got. Not everybody has the talents you got, but every last one of y'all have a gift. God has blessed you with a gift. And the word of God is real. God's word is real. Everything you speak about, and I'm going to talk about it right now, everything you talk about happens. You ever notice you talk about something that happens? Everything happens. I wish one of y'all one day say, Pastor, going to be a millionaire. Come on now. Come on now. I wouldn't know what to do with it if I was a millionaire. But we got to speak about good things. Prayers go up, blessings come down. Say it with me. Prayers go up, blessings come down. Everything you pray about, open up your hands. God will give it to you. Every single thing, we are fighting it spiritual every day. But God's word, everything that comes out of your mouth is a weapon. Do you know right now, have you ever seen that movie, Lethal Weapon? You ever seen that movie, the Bruce Lee movies? Bruce Lee always wins the fight. They're like, why? 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 You ever seen him? Y'all better be laughing at me. Why? You know, every time we fight, yeah, Bruce Lee, yeah, woo! It's a fight, isn't it? You're fighting every single day just like that. You're doing it spiritually. You don't even know you're fighting the devil. You ever like Bruce Lee every day? Something happens. My wife, she quits her job. She's worried about this, or I'm worried about something in football, or something happens. I'm fighting every day. It's a constant battle. My kids still calling me. My phone's still ringing. I'm like, oh, man. You know what? I got kids and grandkids, and I got a daughter at the house. I'm like, oh, my God. I'm into a fight every single day. Then I got to keep fighting. But you know what I learned? The word of God, all I got to do is stop and say, God, help me, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Come on, put your hands together for that word, Jesus. You got to stop sometimes. Slow down, grasshopper. Slow down. Quit rushing things. What's that word? Umswa. Umsa. How did I say it? Umsa. What did he say? Musa. Wusa. Wusa, I'm sorry. Wusa. Slow down. Listen to what God's telling you. You can fight the devil with the word of God. Every single day you can fight, no matter what you're going through. The next thing I want to talk about, guys, we need to spend more time with God. We need to spend more time with God by changing our hearts. Changing our hearts. Changing what we used to do. And I know that's hard to change your heart because you used to doing things your way. You're not used to doing God's way. You're used to doing everything your way. We have to change our hearts. If we don't change our hearts, we're going to still be doing the same things we were doing 5 or 10 years ago. Talking the same. Do y'all remember y'all was 15 years ago how you used to be? Do you remember how you used to be? How did you used to be 15 years ago? You talked different, didn't you? You looked different, didn't you? Some of y'all had on bell bottoms, didn't you? Y'all remember Michael Jackson pants he had on, beaded pants? Does anybody remember those? I used to wear the parachute pants. Y'all had those? I might have those. No, I'm talking about Michael Jackson pants. Anybody had those? The Michael Jackson pants? Y'all remember them? Y'all go to school? Y'all remember Michael Jackson pants, anybody? I know my wife used to wear them. Did you swear them? The Michael Jackson pants back in the day? Yeah, back then. Michael Jackson pants. The MC Hammer pants. Anybody remember those? Y'all remember them? How you used to be?
I still got them.
He's still wearing them. Look at him, y'all. He's still wearing MC Hammer pants. But 15 years ago, you was completely different. Your heart was different. You talked different. My wife used to cuss like a sailor. Every other word. What? I'm talking about every other word. I'm like, wow, are you serious? A lot of us are like that. Just like the kids, they lie all day long. Do y'all cuss on the playground? Hold your hands up. Every last kid cusses on the playground. Don't lie in the church. Because we used to do it. We used to do it. You in that playground, the girls' tunnel, you get kicked out the girls' tunnel. We all did this. These are things we did. We were different then. But as you got older, you start to look at things. As you get to look at things, you're thinking about the future. The future. But you have to change your heart. Change the way you talk. Quit talking about people behind their backs. They did this to Jesus Christ. Amen? They talked about Jesus. They spit on him. They didn't like him. They didn't care what everything he did. But you know what? I learned I had to change my heart. And spending more time with God. So Some Christians say they're Christians, but they're not Christians. Hallelujah. You don't know any people that say they're Christians, but really, outside, as soon as they leave here, they're not Christians.
Say it again.
Some people are Christians, but say they're Christians, but they're not. I'm going to be honest. They leave this church. As soon as they get out of the church. My wife, the other day, I like talking about my wife because she gives good examples. She said she was on the highway. She cut over. Some dude gave her a birdie. He gave her a birdie yesterday. She said, God bless you. I love you too. And waved back. You see how that is? How good God is? The devil wants you to react back. Back in the day, she probably pulled up. But right now, she said, I love you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. I'm telling you right now, when you change your hearts, things will start to happen to you supernaturally. God will start to let you know that he's going to change your life. He's going to change everything you do, but you got to change first of all. Can you go to the scripture? Matthew 12, verse 30 through 31. Come on up here, Mimi. Oh, come on up here, cousin. Come on up here. Matthew 12, verse 30 through 31.
She got it for me. Anyone who isn't with me opposes me, and anyone who isn't working with me is actually working against me. So I tell you, every sin and every blasphemy can be forgiven except for blasphemy against the Holy Spirit, which will never be forgiven.
Hallelujah, amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah. He said, anything that you go against me, you go against God. If you blaspheme, the Holy Spirit is the one sin that God will not forgive you for. Do you know a lot of us are so ungrateful? Some of us know that God has done this. And as soon as we get, well, we got tax season's coming up. You know how many people are not going to go to church? They got a little money. Soon as they get a little money, they forget about God. Y'all know anybody like that? They forget who they forget where they came from. They forget about the hard times they went through. They forget about the ramen noodles. I was talking about y'all just earlier about a spread. I love spreads. Oh, my God. I love spreads. Burritos. Y'all know what a spread is? Y'all, it's penitentiary. They put everything in it. They put burritos in there, nacho chips, beans,
Fritos,
all this stuff. I came home to my wife. I made her a spread. She slapped me. Y'all pray for that sister. She said, don't you ever cook this again. But I'm going to tell you something right now. We need to start changing our ways, the way we talk, by spending more time with God. No, by not blaspheming God. By not talking about people. Because people are exactly, the Bible says God made us in his image. You know when you talk about somebody, you're talking about God? Did y'all know that? When you talk about people, guess what you're doing? You're talking about God. Amen? And I know it's hard to do. I know it's hard when somebody does something wrong to you. But when that dude flipped her off, she could have got into it, but she said, God bless you. Bye-bye. Hi. Bye. Hi. Bye. He was mad. Money. Changing our ways, changing our hearts, changing the way we talk. You know what? I didn't always look this good. Back in the day, I thought I was Tupac. I know y'all know my story. I thought every time I listened to that music, all eyes on me. I had a gun. I had 145 right here. And I had a 40 cal right here. And I remember my boy Black Jesus. I'd go over there every day. We talk about and laugh about things. And I remember the first time I threw a concert in the country. This is in 2001. We threw a concert at my house. Everybody came over there. We had people on the roof. Black girl, come on, play. Grab the computer. I grabbed the computer. We got everything going. We had a big party. But I remember Black Jesus said, you know what? Be careful what you say in your music because it happened to you. And then that next day, I remember it like it was yesterday. I had a buddy named Joker. Joker, didn't he love old Joker? Y'all remember old Joker? We was at the gas station pumping gas, waiting on McDonald's, and sure enough, somebody just said, pop, 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 pop. They shattered us for nothing. Because everything I spoke about in my music, I was trying to be that gangster rapper. I wanted to do this, I wanted to do that. The words you speak out of your mouth, do y'all know that movie? Do you understand the words that are coming out of my mouth? Y'all remember that movie? You have to know the words that come out of your mouth are very powerful. Your words determine where you are today. There's a reason why you're not successful. You know why? Because you're speaking against yourself. You're talking, I can't pay these bills. How am I going to do this and that? Come on now. Jesus, put your hands together. Jesus, I'm not going to be able to do this and that. I can't do this and that. You know why you can't do it? Because you are fighting yourself. The sword, God's word is a weapon. If you use God's word in your behalf, you're able to do these things. The reason you're not successful and you're stressful because of you. It's not because of nobody else. You can blame it on your kids. All like, my kids, they won't do this and that. But you know what? Your kids are sick because you keep talking negative. You keep talking about bad things. The kids are listening. They listen to every single thing. And you know what? When they get to that playground, where do they learn those cuss words from? Ooh. Well, they got you, didn't they? They learn from the other kids. Huh? But they learn from their parents. Whatever, yeah, YouTube, whatever. But their parents, they're hearing their parents talk like this. They're hearing their parents. Soon my daughter hear a word, my daughter be like, we've been listening to music. My daughter be like, you know what, my bubby, he always listen to cuss words, daddy. When he come over, you need to whoop him. My son, 21 years old. She's like, bubby, listen to cuss words. Don't you hear that? Ooh, bubby, listen to cuss words. I'm like, you know what, when I see bubby, I'm going to whoop him. I'm going to get him.
And don't need me
but that's exactly what goes on in our life. What we're talking about, the kids are picking everything up. Everything you're doing, they listen to. They're doing exactly. Guys, you know what? If you think about it, whatever your mom and dad did, you probably did the same thing. You're probably in a situation because of what your mom and dad did. Now you're going through it. But you know what? You can break that curse. Hallelujah. Put your hands together. You can break the minions curse. Today is the day. Somebody say, today is the day. Look at somebody say, today is the day. Today is the day that you change your heart. You're not longer the same. You're no longer thinking you're Tupac like I was, walking around, like I said, with a 45, with a 40 cal. Everywhere I went, I had it on me. Didn't matter. I had it on me. I go to the gas station. I go inside of a store. I had it on me. It didn't matter. Because everything, the Bible even says, you live by, the Bible don't say this, but most people say this, you live by the sword, what? You die by the sword. Can I play? If I'm going to carry a weapon, I'm going to tell you about Big Dude. When I first met Big Dude, this guy was a wonderful man. I'm sitting in the car, and he looked at me, he was serious. He said, man, I need protection. Man, you got a gun? I said, yeah, I got a gun. Oh, yeah, it's cool, cool, man. I appreciate it, man. I said, okay, you just go into church. I'm going to get the gun. I'm going to get it. He said, okay, okay. He was really waiting on that gun. He was like, man, I just got to have some protection. Well, he looked at me. He looked at Craig on Friday. You ever see Craig on Friday when he threw the rock at Debo? He said, I need some protection. I came in the next day with a little Bible. Gave it to him. He said, oh, yeah, that's what I was talking about. He tried to play it off. Oh, yeah, that's what I was talking about anyways. He wanted me to come with a big old gun, a big Tommy gun in here. But you know what? The word of God, he thinks it's funny, but it's the truth in it. I came in with that Bible, and you know what he did with me the next day? He said, man, Pastor. Man, I'm done doing these drugs. I'm done smoking weed. I'm done doing all this. I'm done with these cigarettes. Put your hands together. He said, I'm done with all this, man. I'm ready to go fight with the devil for God. Fight against the devil for God. He gave it to me, put it in my hands. I'm like, what? What you gonna do? I'm scared, Amy. I've never been to a dispensary. I don't even know a dispensary. I don't even know if they even smoke. He handed me something, a big cartridge. Did they call it a cartridge?
A cartridge.
Yeah, so many cartridges. He had a bunch of them too. I was walking. Put it right in the trash can and throw it away. And you know what Chase said? Hey, why'd you do that, Pastor? I wanted that. I said, you know what? He changed his life. He changed his heart. He ain't looked back since. He said, I feel better. I can breathe now. Same thing. I like talking about my wife because she's been so far. I've seen her grow. She used to vape like a sailor. Remember, she's a cousin. Vaped at the same time. Vaping. Our kids are vaping so much, and they are getting away with it. Vape. Kids are vaping nowadays. Y'all know kids are vaping. 11 years old, 8 years old, they're vaping. It's crazy. They are vaping because it's so easy to get.
Younger than that.
But I'm gonna tell you something right now. I watched my wife go through it. And what I would do is I would give her a vape. I'd give it to her every 5 minutes. So I would hold on to it. Hey, about 3 minutes, she's sweating. What's that vape at? No. I kept taking it. I was like, nope, nope. She come around the house, tear up the house. Where's that vape? Where's my vape at? I promise you, when she would lose that vape, everything, the whole house would shake. Boom, boom. You see my vape? I get home, I'm like, what's going on? Where's my vape? I'm like, what? Pepe scared, baby. I'm telling you, the vape is going crazy. She at the store. get me another vape. But I'm telling you right now, she stopped smoking. She said, I'm going to quit smoking. She kept trying and trying. And then one day she stopped smoking. Put your hands together. She stopped smoking, and then Chase started really vaping. Chase started really vaping. Chase vaped more than anybody I know. We call him Mr. Vape Guy, the vaporizer. But I'm going to tell you, God's word is so strong. She started to pray about it. She spent more time with God. She believed she could stop vaping. The same thing my brother did right there. He changed his heart. So I'm telling you, church, right now, change your hearts. Change what you're talking about. Stop vaping. And I'm not just talking about just vaping. I'm talking about stop doing the same things you're seeing on TV so your kids don't pick it up. What you going to do when you walk in and you see your baby vaping 10 years old, open the door, they got a vape or a crack pipe?
Oh my God.
I'm telling you. Kids are doing exactly what they see their parents do. This is real talk. And I know I'm offended a lot of y'all on Facebook and YouTube, but it's real. And you continue to say, oh, my kids would never. My kids would never do that. But it's all different when your kids is in the battle line. Guys yesterday at the football game, gang banging. Oh, yeah, man, you know what I'm saying? I'll go get my gun and air out everybody. Okay, what if somebody went there that your kids is in there? Is that different? That's different then when your kids is involved, ain't it? It's a little bit different if your kids didn't air it out, huh? I'm telling them, like, bro, it's kids in there. What are you talking about? See, people don't think about things until it happens to them. But I'm going to tell you, what goes around comes around. I had to learn that. Like I said, I carried a pistol. And the night I went to jail, I remember like it was yesterday, I pulled my hand out like this, pulled the trigger. Blood flew off of him, hit me everywhere. There was blood all over me. I couldn't believe it. There was so much blood. I've never seen this much blood. I'm with my cousin. My cousin's mad at me. You know what I'm saying? Man, you messed up my Deion Sanders jersey. I said, bro, what are you talking about, man? I just shot somebody. My jersey. I said, man, I just shot somebody. Could you imagine that? Sometimes I have nightmares thinking about that same man I shot. I regret it every day. I'm sorry, my phone probably rang because we had somebody out there from the ambulance. Here you go, can you take this? So when I shot this man, I thought it was the end of my life. Like I said, just like on Friday, y'all remember that? When he thought he shot somebody. So I started feeling bad. Next thing you know, I want to run. I go on the run. But I go to my cousin's grandma, I call her grandma. She made me put on a dress. I'm looking like Big Mama's house, got on makeup. Y'all should have seen me. I was the prettiest big woman you ever seen in your life. I'm not lying to you. Dressed like Big Mama. She put on a big dress, had the blouse on, and put my head over like this, my bra over like this, got socks in here, girdle on here. I'm even walking like her too, you hear me? I'm trying to get out of Oklahoma. I just shot somebody. So I get to Lawton, Oklahoma, y'all. First thing I get to Lawton, Oklahoma. I'm walking in there, hey, how you doing? I go into the casino, can I get an ID? My name is Shaniqua. How you doing? Yeah. I'm telling y'all too. I gotta have makeup on and everything. I put my makeup on. You see how it is? I can't change my heart. When you don't change your heart, you go through so much trouble. It gets worse and worse and worse. And things got worse and worse because I still want to do the same thing over and over and over and over and over and over. But we have to change our hearts. And the last thing I want to talk about today, we need to activate God's power. Keep the sword handy everywhere you go. Be consistent when you read the Bible. Don't just pick up God's word one day and don't read it. Remember God. Remember the ones who put you where you are. God is a jealous God. If I don't do the will of God, if I don't do his works, all the time, y'all, I'm going to tell y'all something real. Sometimes I still think I'm still in prison. I'll be having dreams. Chow out. Camp time. A lot of times, the devil still tells me I'm going back to prison. But maybe I got to go back to prison to help people do prison ministry. I don't know what it is. But I have to be consistent. If I fall off one time, I go back to jail or I end up dead. But I'm telling you right now, church, I challenge you guys to listen to what God is telling you to change your life. Stay in God's will. Stay in God's word. Listen to what he has to say. Can you stand up for a second? You know what? Today's message is called Swing Your Sword. I want y'all to keep swinging your sword. Keep fighting every single day. Keep fighting the good fight. Keep telling the enemy that you are a conqueror. You are more than a conqueror. So, Father God, I pray in the name of Jesus. Lord, I just want to praise and worship you right now, Father. Lord, I just claim victory right now, Lord, and I ask that your will be done in our hearts, in our minds, in our souls. Lord, that right now, Lord, we're coming to victory, Lord. That we're able to pick up the sword, Lord. That we're able to fight the fight. And Lord, we know that no matter what we go through, your word says, no weapon formed against us shall prosper. So Lord, I honor you today. Father, I praise and worship you, Lord. And I know right now, Lord, that you have a plan, Lord. That right now that somebody's going through it on YouTube. Somebody's going through it in here. But remember, you're the one holding yourself back. Because God put the word right in your life. He's gave you an opportunity to tell you he loves you. So I want y'all to repeat after me. Eyes bowed, eyes closed, heads bowed. I accept Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. And I believe he rose on the third day. When you pray that prayer, I want you to really mean that prayer. That you'll never go back to be the same person you used to do. That you don't got to bait behind somebody's back and talk about people's back, talk about people. Because that's what we're doing. But Lord, in the name of Jesus, I speak against any enemy, against the devil right now, Lord. That you forgive everyone for their sins, Lord. That they are renewed right now in the name of Jesus. Come on, y'all, put your hands together. In the name of Jesus. That you are set free today. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. See, God's going to see you right now. He's going to see you everything you need. But you got to be ready for it. You got to be ready for it. Because it's a spiritual battle. And know you can fight the enemy with his word. I want you to continue to swing your sword at the devil. The devil's scared of you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Right now, I just ask whatever you can give right now. Whatever you put in there, believe that God's going to multiply it. Believe it. God's going to multiply whatever you put in there. Believe it. God can multiply everything like he does in fish and bread. Believe it. If you believe God can multiply, you put it in there, believe it. He will multiply everything in your life. In the name of Jesus, I want to thank you, Lord. Lord, I pray for those in need. I pray for the elderly, the poor, the sick. That this ministry will help people. Help us grow over and over and over and over. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I want to thank everybody for coming out to Unified Family Church. Make sure you check us out on YouTube. Make sure you press the like button too. Everybody, repeat after me. Unified Family! We love you. We're one. It's time to give you a second hand. Come on, man. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Come on, now. Come on, now. It goes. He says yes.
We say yes.
Somebody say yes. You see, God, when he answers your prayers, he's not going to say no. He's going to say yes. Yes. Yes, come on now. God said, he told me to tell you yes. He's going to answer your prayers. Come on, say it with me now, y'all. Somebody say yes. Oh, yeah. Come on. Yes. God has already answered your prayers. It's called confirmation. It's called confirmation. In the name of Jesus. Come on, church, say it with me.
He said yes.
Come on now. Yes. He's never gonna leave you lonely. He's never gonna leave you lonely. He's
shit upon his hands. Come on, man. Come on, everybody, see another hand.
He's
saying, God's gonna okay, you know.
He's
saying,
the
Bible says that God will never leave you, nor forsake you. Come on, man. He's got your back. He's got your back. But people have your back. But everybody lied on you. God was there for you. He was there for you. Come on, man. Yeah.